Listen, could you get him to make the tea? Yes, make give the him tea. A shove.
Okay, I'll go and make the tea.
Go on, go on, right. Time you did a bit of work, you lazy thing. Anyway, so do you know, isn't it ridiculous when you think about it? A programme that just has basically the settee and a telly.
I know.
Amazing.
And yet it works, and it's great fun to do. You know, that settee is one, it's comfier than this. It's so old and flea-bitten, I hate to think where it came from and who sat on it, but it is so comfortable that we stay on it and we'll squash all four of us on it if there's four of us, and that leave Ralph's chair, Anthony's chair, empty because we all like cuddling on this.
Yes, it's best really job you've sad. Had all your life, I guess.
It's the easiest, yeah. I just laugh all day. It's wonderful.
What was the prediction for the show originally? Because it was on BBC Two originally, sort of tucked away a bit, wasn't it?
Yes, and I think they'd have been happy with that, and I don't think we expected anything else. But I always thought, from the minute that they sent the scripts, I thought, this is wonderful. I just think this is really different. And so I thought it would be successful, but never as successful as it has been. It's just been unbelievable, really.
Award-winning. I mean, it's up for so many nominations all the time, isn't
yes,
it? But
yes.
You mentioned script. In fact, it's a great accolade, in a way, to the script writers. To Caroline Ahern and what are the name of the other chap?
Well, it's the first. It was Caroline, and it was Caroline's idea. Caroline and Craig Cash, and they've been constant on both series. And we've done a Christmas
Paul,
special.
Look at this boy.
You're a good boy.
Thank you. Very good, Paul. Thanks so much.
We want several more, actually.
Yes, exactly. So sorry, you were saying about the script.
The first series was Craig and Caroline and Henry Normal, who writes for Steve Coogan, but then that sort of started taking more of his time up. So he went, and Carmel Morgan came in on the last series. So it's always three. But Caroline and Craig really are the main input.
And had you been used to doing comedy, or is this
no.
a fairly new field for you?
I'd done comedy in the theatre, but I'd never done anything like this. But it's the scripts, you know, and it's because it's very real, you know, it's... you're not acting funny, you're just being truthful. It's all there, you know.
Yes, it's
rich.
Poignant,
you know.
Sad.
Oh, yes, yes.
A mixture of all emotions, really.
Well, my mum says it's her, isn't it? You've been telling people, haven't you, you know? She said, because, you know, I make gravy.
I say,
yes. Well, I make gravy, and I always use a china cup. But there are sort of things in it like Nana is my mum. And I think lots of people recognise dad's mum's brother, the kid who has to do everything, you know, get up and the slave, you know, at the end of the sofa.
Obviously, I have to mention Brookside, because you got a huge break with Brookside.
I stayed
with her for something like 9 years. But when you left, many people thought, like a few other soap stars, that maybe, you know, it just things wouldn't work out so well, a bit of oblivion.
Oh, yes.
In fact, things had never been better.
No, it was a risk, and it was a bit frightening. And but I'd worked a lot in theatre, and I thought I could always go back to that. But I knew I had to do something else. I'd done as much as I could with that. My mum and dad thought I was insane because I had a young child to bring up, to give up a job. But it's sort of like you think, well, I'm just going in every day and I'm not being challenged and I'm going to be boring because I'm bored, sort of thing.
Or typecast.
Or typecast, yes, if you stay too long. And I would never criticise anybody who stays in a soap. You make that choice. And I kept thinking, I wish I could. You know, I wish I hadn't been like me that needed to do something else, because it was a lovely life. And but I did need to do something else. And Touch wood
has worked out
terribly
very
well. Yeah.
You're talking about doing something else. I find it hysterical that you worked in the tax office at one point.
I did.
Well, how old were you?
I started in the tax office when I was 18. I sort of got a bit rebellious because I wanted to go into acting. My parents wouldn't let me. My dad desperately wanted me to go to university, and I was in the sixth form and sort of left in a bit of a strop. And my uncle said, why don't you go into the civil service? Because he was a chief inspector of taxes. So I went in as a tax officer and I worked in Liverpool, but on North John Street, and going off North John Street was Matthew Street, where the cavern was, so it was a great location. But I hated it.
Were you good at it?
No, I was terrible. And I was always being called in to the inspector, because I used to feel so sorry for people when they came in, and I used to have post hidden people
supposed to... Hide
their bills of tax and sort of just do the easy ones and sort of get rid of all the other ones.
You sure you don't want to go back into my tax office for a day or two?
I could do, couldn't I? Yes, I think people were very fortunate when they got me.
Now, spinning forward, I mean, obviously you're going to have a very busy time coming up to Christmas because you're at the National Theatre with the mystery plays.
Oh, yes.
Now, explain it, because they come, what, in three parts, really?
Yes, there's three mystery plays. There's The Passion... Well, there's a lot of mystery plays, they're the old mystery plays, and this is... Tony Harrison's done a combination of the York, Coventry, Wakefield, and... Well, I think there's the best thing you could ever see for the millennium, and that's why it's being done.
So the
first one
nativity.
Is The Nativity, mm-hmm. The Passion, and Doomsday. And you can watch it, or the audience can promenade on the floor with the action, and... it's just magical. There's some extra... And it's for kids, grown-ups, anybody. It's just magical. Some of the things are so moving. I watched Adam and Eve, the two kids playing Adam and Eve. They were just trying it technically. They come... God makes them out of the earth, and you don't know they're there in this garden. And they come up out of the earth. And they're so beautiful, these two, and it's... So moving.
Well, as you say, it's wonderful for Christmas and millennium.
Oh, yes, absolutely. And, well, there's just such magic things, the effects, but there's a wonderful one in The Passion, which is a much simpler play, where Joe Dittine, this lovely actor, carries the cross with his thorn of crowns, and it's a real cross, because if your audience are next to you, you have to have something that real.
And like the weight of it and everything.
The weight of it, and he comes round dragging this cross with the soldiers, you know, and you think, you suddenly get... And then they put him on it and haul him up. And it's extraordinary, because you suddenly get this, you know, it's lodged, whether you're a believer or not a believer, it's lodged the myth or your belief in this man who was crucified.
So it takes your breath away a little bit, doesn't it?
Oh, yes, it's extraordinary.
So will you get Christmas Day and Boxing Day off?
We get from... Yes, we finish on the 23rd.
So are you cooking, then?
I will be cooking, yeah. I always do the cooking at home. I love it.
Do you love Christmas at home?
I love Christmas at home. But... I don't know what I'll do for the millennium, do you? I can't make my mind up.
I know, I keep changing my mind. Yes. And 1 minute's a big deal, and the next minute everybody's saying, oh, it's just another year.
I know,
but I always try that Christmas tea, because Paul will never forgive you if you don't drink it. Do you think?
Actually,
like you
did
coffee. A good job. Good cup of tea, Paul.
Thank you.
Oh, is
excellent. Cheers. Do you think he's got a chance at all in the Royle Family? Could you work him in?
He
could do a bit of cooking
for
me in the kitchen.
Yeah, I could be the chef.
I could, yeah, he'd be very good in the kitchen. You could make the gravy.
Sue, so it's always a delight to see you, and I wish you all the very best for
Thank
your
you.
Christmas. Playing, of course, Mary. What a perfect
Mary
role
mother,
for Christmas.
Mary Senior.
Mary the Mother. But no, but nevertheless. No,
but I get to ascend into heaven.
Oh, well, there you can't get much better than that, can you? Sue, thank you very much indeed
thank
for
you.
Joining us.